الحمد لله رب العالمين، نحمد ونصلي على رسوله الكريم. أما بعد، فأعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. اللهم صل وسلم على نبينا محمد. With the mercy and blessing of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in our journey through the seerah, we are going to talk about Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam uswai hasana. Okay? And let us say as much durood on the Prophet as much possible while we are going through the seerah of the Prophet, right? And inshallah, we will answer all the questions. I have noted down your questions here, so inshallah, we will answer them. At this time, I want you to focus on the word uswatun hasana. All right, the word is uswatun hasana. So go ahead, let me know, what do you mean? What is the meaning of uswatun hasana? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Suratul Ahzab, verse number 21, that laqad kana lakum fi rasulillahi uswatun hasana. And alhamdulillah, beautiful. Yes, you're writing correctly. Uswatun hasana means role model. Good job, Ishal. And we need to see, as we look at this ayah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala reminding us that indeed in the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you have a good example to follow. But for whom? For whom is that good example? There is a criterion. And I want you to write down in your notes that criterion and see if you qualify for that. So the number one is liman. For whom? Kana is yarjullaha. For whom? For him who hopes in the meeting with Allah. Wal yawm al akhir, and the last day. Wa dhakar allaha kathira, and remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala much. Now question is, what is another name for all these, right? What is another name for hoping to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the last day? Can anybody think of another name for this? When are we going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Or when will the unseen become seen for us and we will start seeing what, you know, we have not been seeing right now? Beautiful, Hafsa, Judgment Day. Okay, excellent. And what will come even before that? What is the first time we're going to start seeing the angels? Beautiful, Zainab, excellent. MashaAllah, Tabarakallah. That will be our time of death. Okay? And whether we like it or not, we all have to go back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no stopping there. There is no stopping there. All right. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said that أَكْثِرُ ذِكْرَ حَاذِمِ اللَّزَّاتِ. Abu Huraira radiallahu anha reported that Rasulullah sallallahu said that remember often the destroyer of pleasures, yani al-maut. All right. So when we think of this ayah, when we look at this, and when we think about the topic of uswatun hasana, yes, everything looks great. Rasulullah was a great role model. But what I'm going to do, I'm just going to keep sitting and keep playing on my PlayStation. I'm going to keep sitting and keep on doing and snoozing until, you know, that's going to happen until I can set my focus right. So it's very important to highlight that this great role model, this great example will materialize in my life if I am, you know, oriented in the right way. And that is that I remember Allah much. Wa dhakaru Allah kathira. I remember that I'm going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala very soon. Right? And alhamdulillah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us that we be able to do justice and we be able to live our life in a mindful way. All right? How many of us do that? Go ahead and type one if you do remember, if you do think about returning back to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then you do check your actions based on that and try to see where do I stand. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to do that. Now this word uswatun hasana comes around three times in the Quran. One time here, the second time you're going to see it in Surah Mumtahinna. And here in this surah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says there's already been for you an excellent pattern in Ibrahim alayhi salam, right? How many of us look forward to running and meeting him and giving him a big tight hug in Jannatul Firdaus, inshallah, right? Alhamdulillah. And walladhina ma'ahu, and those with him, when they said to their people, indeed we are disassociated from you and from whatever you worship other than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Now, this surah is a test of your relationships. This surah is like a test about confirmation about what we say. We say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, but when it comes to practice, where do we stand? This surah is a great test about that. In the first part, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about the love and hatred in the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to avoid the friendships with the polytheist and inviting Muslim to take the inspiration from the great role model, the great legacy of Ibrahim alayhi salam. The second part is about the women who migrate to testify and attest them and discuss, you know, there were many rules and regulations around that. And there is this beautiful dua. I hope you can highlight this in your notes right now, that person who tries to follow the uswatun hasana of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam or the uswatun hasana of Ibrahim alaihi salam, they will have to make use of this dua a lot, because when you will start applying this knowledge in your life, there will be a separation. There will be people who will say that, oh, you are taking too long. There will be people who will say, oh, isn't that too much that you're doing, right? When is this gonna stop now? Right? Subhanallah, that resonates with the question, Zainab, that you asked earlier. I ponder upon the ayahs and with concentration, I pray my salah, but my family members say that I pray too long. Is it wrong? No, it's not wrong, sweetie. Right? We are given the wisdom when to do the right thing. I hope when we are praying salah, we are not in the way of anybody. And definitely when we start applying this Quran, we start giving the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The rights that we had earlier given to the creation, they do come back and start questioning that. So here comes this powerful dua that Rabbana alayka tawakkalna wa ilayka anabna wa ilayka al-masir. Right? So how many of us pledge sitting here in this classroom that inshallah, I will try to be a mindful person and I will try to follow the uswatun hasana. If I know it, then I will show it. Go ahead and type 5. And we will make this a dua for reliance. Our Lord, upon you we have relied, and to you we have returned, and to you is the final destination. MashaAllah, barakallah fi on all these 5s. All right. And I can read it once, right? But we are not talking about that. Yes, you can definitely read Seal Nectar. You can definitely benefit from it, inshallah. Okay, age is one thing, but you know, wisdom is a bigger thing. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us, you know, indulge in reading and help increase our intellect, inshallah. Now, the same word uswatun hasana comes in the same surah in verse number 6. And here again, I want you to focus and highlight these words that laqad kana lakum fihim. You know, in all these that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala talks about, Israel Mumtana, then there is an excellent example for you to follow for those who look forward to Yarujullaha wal Yawmal Akhir. Is that the same thing or different? Go ahead and type same or different. Is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asking, you know, reminding us with the similar way or different? And wa man yatawalla fa inna Allaha huwal ghaniyyul hamid. Beautiful, Zainab. Excellent, Abdurrahman. It's the same thing. The same requirement. Who will take heed from the life and legacy of the Prophet ﷺ? Somebody who is smart enough to know there is a creator who created this world. Somebody who is smart enough to know that even if I touch my eyelashes, go ahead and feel your eyelashes. Go ahead and feel your hands. Go ahead and see all your, you know, take a deep breath and just look all around you. Subhanallah. Isn't that incredible how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created this world and this alternation of the day and night? These are indeed signs for those who understand. And such a person who looks forward to meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. By the way, how do you feel when you think of meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Go ahead and tell me your emotions. Like, you know, we talk often like we are, you know, learning digitally, and sometimes we get very associated with people, like, you know, when we listen to their audios or videos, or, you know, we learn something from some teachers across the oceans and we look forward to meeting that person. Our heart is full of love and gratitude of meeting that person. But when we think about meeting Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Right? Alhamdulillah, how do I feel? This is amazing what you're writing, mashallah. Because how you feel is how, you know, how you hope, that's how you're going to meet Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us that we meet him in a way that he is pleased with us and we are pleased with him, right? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those who are pleased to be worshippers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Yes, barakallahu. Yes, we want to thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for everything and relief from the evils of this world. That is so true, Muhammad, right? Like, you know, like this for a believer, this dunya is like a sijin. It's like a prison because there's so much. Like when you start thinking about it, every little thing, every little thought, every little action, even if you're doing a good action, it just makes you scared. Like Allah protect this from ria. Allah protect this from any other intentions, subhanallah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this world, these the believers are yatakhafatun. They are like continuously fearing and hoping. Allah, you know, bless you in that, inshallah. Yes, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allahumma inna nas'aluka ladhata an-nadhr ila wajhik, may Allah give us a life in which we meet him in a way that he is pleased with us. And the same ayah, the five also, in the ayah number five, I just included this here for you that, you know, this is a beautiful dua because such a person is such a misfit in this world. People think of it, oh no, this person is like, who is, I don't know what they are up to. What are they doing? So make this dua, Rabbana la taj'alna fitnatan lilladhina kafaru waghfir lana Rabbana. Our Lord, make us not objects of trials for the disbelievers and forgive us. Our Lord, indeed it is you who is the exalted and might, the wise. So beautiful surah to read more about and set our role models right. Alhamdulillah. And we are again reminded that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was the best of the role model. And when we know this, then we should show this. If we claim that we love the Prophet ﷺ, if we claim we look forward to meeting him, if we claim that we are the Muslims who are the best of the nations, then we have to do action because knowledge demands action, right? And I had given a character challenge yesterday. So go ahead and type one if yes, you did do the character challenge. And what happened with that character challenge? So what... When you ask your family, go ahead. I'm going to give you the link right here and go ahead and type in what happened when you spoke with your family and you asked them that, you know, how is my character? What happened at that time? So it's really, really important for us to show what we know, right? And what did they say? How does my family try to do it? If you are telling me that I'm going to do it today, then that means maybe we didn't listen yesterday properly, right? So in your life, always try to listen and do not procrastinate. Do not leave things for tomorrow. Okay, keep things on the time. If you keep this habit in your life that I'm going to do my work, whatever it is assigned that day, I will finish it that day. Your days will become much more productive, inshallah. Okay. So let's see if I have any friends who did go back and ask your family that what happened. Okay, and if you miss anything, you can always benefit from the recordings, inshallah, and benefit from that. So yes, I will keep this on the side and remind ourselves that, you know, just knowing is not important. Showing is something super important, and may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us be reminded that the best of the believers are those, and the best of the believers are those who are the best in character, right? They can say, they act on, they apply what they have learned, alhamdulillah, and they are kind to their families. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us of those, inshallah. And here we did the dua, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when we think about uswatun hasana, let's say with full consciousness and mindfulness, Allahumma kama hasanta khalqi fa hassin khuluqi. Oh Allah, as you have made my physical form beautiful, so make my character really beautiful. Barakallah fi on for all those who are, mashallah, sharing their responses, and they are, you know, they are able to, they did ask their families, and mashallah, beautiful, beautiful responses, right? Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us have, you know, the best and the best of the character, inshallah. And with that, just remember that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala enable us to have the best of character. All right, so we stop here with the seerah session with the durood. Allahumma salli wa sallim ala nabijina Muhammad.